Yes, welcome all. So in this video, we'll be discussing about the model 2, that is according to the syllabus model 2, that is velocity and acceleration analysis of method by graphical method. In this model, so we have a graphical method and we have an analytical method. So this is a model number 2 according to the syllabus, that is velocity and acceleration analysis of mechanisms in the graphical method. See, in this we are going to study about the mainly about the motion, acceleration and the velocity. And then we are going to study about the instantaneous centers. Then we are going to study about the Kennedy's theorem. Then we are going to solve about the numericals on the different conditions. So mainly in this, how the velocity and acceleration will affect the mechanism. See, first we need to analyze the velocity and at what velocity the mechanism is moving. And at what acceleration the mechanism is moving. So directly on the naked eyes we cannot able to identify, since we need to analyze in the different factors. Then only we can able to identify what is the exact velocity and acceleration of that particular analysis of that mechanism. So in this video, we're going to be discussing about the velocity of two bodies moving in a straight line. So to find out the velocity of a two bodies, whenever the two bodies moving in a straight line, and the motion of a link, how the motion in the link can able to takes place. So first we'll say about the velocity of a two bodies moving in a straight line. So velocity of a two bodies moving in a straight line. You can able to see the velocity of body of moving in a straight line. We have been taken example, that is figure A and figure B, where VA, velocity of body A, and velocity of the body B. So first mainly we're going to discuss about the applications of vectors and for the relative velocity of the two bodies along the parallel lines or any even inclined lines. So majorly first we're going to see about the applications of the vectors for the relative velocity of the bodies moving along with the parallel and an inclined lines. So first considering a considering the two bodies A and B moving along the parallel lines in the same direction with absolute velocities. We can able to see a body moving in the same direction, that is with the absolute velocity with VA and VB. So VA is greater than VB as shown in the figure. So the relative velocity of A with respect to B. So when we comparing with the relative velocity with the body A with respect to B, then the vector difference will be VA and VB will be equal to vector VA and minus vector VB. So this is how when we can able to find out the relative velocity of A and B. So from figure we can see the relative velocity of A with respect to B may be written in the vector as follows. Now we can able to see the relative vector A and the vector B, where you can able to see VAB, that is vector AB and vector BA. So this is how we can able to find out the difference of vectors, that is vector difference of VA and VB. Coming to next. So similarly, the relative velocity of B with respect to A. See, first we have been identified similarly with respect to the A to B. So next we are going to identify the vector difference B to A, that is from B to with respect to A. Now vector AB will be equal to the vector difference of VA and VB will be. Now we need to find out the what is the exact vector difference of VA and VB. Now consider the body B moving in an inclined direction as shown in the figure. So we need to consider the body which is moving in the inclined direction. So the relative velocity of A with respect to B may be obtained by the law of parallelogram of the velocities or the law of triangle of velocities. So take any fixed point O and draw the vector to O to A. We can able to see. Take a fixed point to the in this diagram, we can able to see the vector A and the vector B. So where we can able to draw a line from O to A, from this point where O to A, and represent VA in magnitude and direction to some suitable scale. So we're going to representing the suitable scale and direction, that is magnitude and direction to that to for some extension of that scale. So then the vector BA represents the relative velocity of A with respect to B as shown in the figure. So in the similar way as we discussed about the relative velocity of A and with respect to B, now we can able to see this is a relative velocity of two bodies moving along inclined lines. So initially first what we have been seeing, the relative velocity of two bodies moving along the parallel lines. So here we are going to see the relative velocity of the two bodies moving along the inclined lines. We can able to see vector VA and vector VB. So now this is a parallelogram or what we call it as a law of triangles of velocity. So we have been drawn a line with a suitable scale of OA, that is a vector A representing, and we have been drawn a line along with that parallelogram VB. So that is vector AB, this is vector A and this is vector B. So we have been joined both the vector AB, that is it forms as a law of triangle, or we can able to consider as a law of parallelogram. Now the relative velocity of a two bodies moving along the in-kind lines. So now the VA, so VAB is the vector difference of VA and VB. So similarly the relative velocity of B with respect to A, what is a similar velocity we need? So the velocity of the vector BA will be equal to vector difference of VB and VA. So the difference is nothing but VA and VB. So since the with respect to, when we consider with respect to B, automatically it will be VB and VA. From above this both the parallel and inclined lines, we can conclude that the relative velocity of a point A and B and the relative velocity of point B and A are equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. Both the A and B and B and A will be equal in magnitude but opposite in the direction. So this is how we can able to find out the relative velocities of bodies moving along with the straight lines and then a parallel lines. So next we're going to discuss about the motion of the link. See, for any movement, the mainly the motion. The motion is nothing but change of position with respect to time or velocity or an acceleration or with respect to displacement. So here, considering a two points AB and a rigid link as shown in the figure. So considering a two points, that is AB rigidly fixed on a link. Let one of the extremities B of the link move relative to A in a clockwise direction. We can able to see that. See, is B moving relative to the clockwise direction. Since the distance from A to B remains the same, therefore there can be no relative motion between A and B along the line and line AB. Since both this A and B is fixed with a certain distance, so since there will be no velocity along with this line A and B, in this obvious the relative motion B with respect to A must be perpendicular to AB. Since because we have formed in a one more, that is a vector vector BA. So then there will be a relative motion between this vector B and the link B. So that is what how the motion of any link can be formed. Now, so hence the velocity of any point on a link with respect to another. Hence velocity of any point on a link with respect to another point on the same link will be always perpendicular to the link joining these points on the configuration or what we can able to see in this diagram, in this space diagram. So the relative velocity of B with respect to A, that is what the vector BA is represented by the vector AB, is perpendicular to the line AB as shown in the figure, as shown in this figure AB, we can able to see this. So we know that the velocity at a point B with respect to A will be, what the velocity we can able to get with respect to point B is vector BA will be equal to M into AB. So magnitude, that is M into AB. Similarly the velocity of point C and AB with respect to A, so that is at vector CA, M into AC, we can able to see this vector VABC. So from the equation on 1 and 2, what we can able to get, so the vector CA will be equal to, see this vector CA will be equal to M into AC. So what is that AC is nothing but from point A to C, what is the vector. And similarly the vector BA, from vector B to A, that will be equal to M into AB. So now thus we can see from the equation 3 that the point C and the vector AB divides the same ratio. Since this point C, that is a vector point C, what is there, that divides the point A and B on that particular link with respect to AB. See, similarly with respect to AB, A and B, we have been drawn a line which is joined and there is no relative motion, hence it is fixed and it is been formed as a vector BA. Since we have been drawn the point as a C, now this C divides the link AB. So this is how we can able to consider any two points and a rigid link and how the motion can able to be takes place in the mechanism. As we know that to form any mechanism, the group of links will be in a the group of links will form in a mechanism. But to group of links, initially we required some motion. What might be the motion and how the motion will be formed, that is mainly depends upon the links. So to, normally to form or any motion or any mechanism, minimum two links should be there. So based on that link only the motion can able to be transmitted. So n number of links can be used in order to transmit the motion, but minimum two links should be there. At least one link should be fixed in order to transmit the motion. Thank you.